Welcome back. There's a lot of conversation happening around race right now, and one woman is using her unique experience as a combat pilot and a police officer to weigh in.
Yeah, I spoke to Vernice Armour, who was America's first African-American female combat pilot. She's become an entrepreneur and a speaker in Virginia who's working to make a difference. Hear her story, starting off with how she got her awesome nickname, FlyGirl.
Well, you know, in the military, we call it a call sign, like Iceman, Maverick, right? I was at an event with Michelle Nichols, Lieutenant Uhura, Mae Jemison, and we were doing an event for young girls. It was in a reservist armory. So, of course, I went to go see the guys in the flight equipment room, saw a name tag, it had FlyGirl on it. I said, that's cool. Can I get that? He gave me one. I started wearing it. People started calling me FlyGirl. I said, hey, wait a minute. This is pretty cool. Oh. So I added it to my name and my birth certificate.
Oh, wow. That's incredible. I love that.
But definitely the branding.
Okay, so what made you get into the military and want to get in the air in the first place?
So honestly, I never wanted to be a part of the military. I wanted to be a cop that rode a horse downtown. I was born in Chicago. You know, you grow up, you see the horses. And when I got to college, I didn't have any money to go to school with. Saw a flyer on the wall, said free trip to Mardi Gras. All you had to do was join ROTC. Said, sign me up. My dad was in the military. My stepdad was in the military. My grandfather was a Mumford Point Marine. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I said, I got this military thing. And I felt that it could give me an advantage for getting into police academy. So I ended up going in, enlisting in the Army, becoming a cadet. Yeah. Eventually went on to become a police officer, but could not forget about my military experiences, especially seeing a black woman in a flight suit, which definitely planted the seed.
Right.
So here I am. History.
So what's it like being up in the air? I would freak out. Is it something that you had to get used to, or did you automatically connect with it the first time you were up there?
Well, I think there are some physiology things that you probably have to get used to. There you go. It's like you were giving PTSD flashbacks, but it's like a roller coaster without wheels. It's absolutely amazing. Absolutely amazing.
So they're just staying in the military, cleared hot. You're now using that term and applying it to the real world and with corporate companies. Tell us about that.
Right. Well, when I was in combat, before we could release our weapons and take out a target, we had to get permission from the ground controller. And he would actually say, you have permission to engage, cleared hot. Well, here at home, there are no ground controllers in life. Mm-hmm. You are your ground controller. If you don't give yourself permission, who will? Right. So when we are looking at our workforce, when we're looking at how we engage with our leadership, how we engage with our marketplace, are we giving ourselves permission to engage and fill the gap, innovate, especially now we have COVID going on, an economic recession, topped by social justice movement. Mm-hmm. We have to think outside the cockpit, adapt, flex, and innovate. I mean, I was even in a tough position in my business, right? Think about it. I depend on large groups of people to come together for conferences. So that flexibility and adaptability, that innovation piece was huge for me, as for so many entrepreneurs.
Lastly, what is your mission right now?
That's a good one. Honestly, my mission is to bring us together as one community, one nation, under God, indivisible. Why? Because when I saw George Floyd take his last breath, I said, okay, I'm a former cop, former soldier, former National Guardsman, diversity officer for headquarters, Marine Corps, right? On a committee for putting diversity policy together for all the services. And on this side, an openly gay black woman. I have a unique perspective, and I realized that, but in the moment, I didn't know how to connect the dots. Mm-hmm. And I said, if I don't know how to connect the dots, how does the white mom in suburbia connect the dots?
Right.
So I quickly found my voice to be able to give that different perspective on not answering for every cop or every National Guardsman or every black person, right? Mm-hmm. But I definitely have a voice and leadership to lend to this conversation, which is why I created the new conversation. Actively transforming a company, culture, and country.
That was a really great conversation. Really great to hear from her.
Absolutely. Very inspiring.
Guys, coming up next, if you're struggling with ideas on lunch for your kids, you